This is a tutorial for our targeted case managers on the basic functions and also how to service capture for targeted case management services. So very first thing after logging in, double check that your caseload is accurate. Caseload is located at the bottom under My Students. You can edit to add students, to remove students. You can also create groups if so be. But otherwise, focus on the add and remove just to make sure that your caseload is accurate. You will use a report to find out who on your caseload is a Medicaid billable student, and that's found under case management called billable students on caseload TCM for targeted case management. This is going to tell you who on your caseload fits all of the criteria for Medicaid billing. It's also going to point out with a yes under each one of these columns who that is. So the OT will have a yes for direct service. So you know when you see a student on this that you have a direct service provider listed and you as a teacher can go ahead and bill for targeted case management. So that is a report that you should check once a month to double check and make sure that you are billing for those students. So you are going to go up to Service Capture, Service Calendar, and that's going to bring you your caseload on your left side pane. You will select the student that you're going to bill for, and then you are going to select a date in the month that you are going to report the services. Make sure it's a day that you and the student are present. So we are going to select the 5th. There are two different ways you can do this. You can do the drop down for services and click record past services, brings up another calendar, go ahead and select date and hit OK. Or you can just right click on the date you want to bill and then select record past services. This brings up the service record. So you'll see the student and the staff, the date, go ahead and select a time you are going to record the services. And then under service, you're going to select targeted case manager, and the service type, you are going to select targeted case management services that you're going to be reporting once a month per student that's billable. Go ahead and put in a number for duration. There is no specific requirement on that. Progress report. So how is that student doing this month? And you can put in what's appropriate. And then for provider notes, you will put in note that is how you are coordinating anything that's related to their IEP. So you are going to put in any direct contact that you have with the direct service providers. So OT, PT, speech, social work, you can put that in there. You can put in if you talked to a parent, if you consulted with staff regarding the student, all of that is Medicaid billable options. So make sure you list that there. And then you are going to select area covered, go ahead and select the appropriate option, and then you're going to select has the service been completed, check mark that yes, and hit save. So every time that you do a targeted case management service each month, you need to follow that up at the end of the month with a monthly progress summary. So same procedure on how you do a service record. You're going to come back into the service record, a brand new service record, fill in the information. Under service type, you're going to change that to monthly progress summary. The duration, select time, again, select the appropriate progress report. Under provider notes, this is a summary format. So you will go ahead and change this and say, you know, this month the student did this, or this month I consulted with. And the plan moving forward. So we are going to continue with services for social work for this student. And then you'll select area. There's an option here for monthly summary. And then again, same thing, you'll select has a service been completed? Yes, and hit save. And that is the procedure to do a targeted case management and a monthly summary. I would like to point out that there's another option for our targeted case managers, and that is the IEP IFSP participation. This procedure code can be used one time per IEP for each student. So if it's an initial, if it's a reeval, if it's an amendment, If it's a new IP, go ahead and use this code and bill for that. And then that's your new procedure code for that. And that is how you do Medicaid billing for targeted case managers.